Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about branding yourself as a software developer. Okay, so today I want to talk just a little bit about personal branding. And I know it's a bit of a corny subject, but let's talk about it anyway, because I think it's very important for software developers or people of any profession, right? We always have to be thinking, how do we differentiate ourselves from everybody else? It's something I have to think about personally as a professional. It's something I have to think about Overpass as a company. How do we stand out from everybody else? Because there's so much competition and there's fewer jobs all the time. It's constantly, it's like, it's not sustainable, right? We have automation taking away jobs and we have more population coming in taking away jobs. So it's getting very hard to stay employed. And one of the things you have to do if you want to be paid anything decent is to brand yourself. So like my thinking about this changed about 17 or 18 years ago. I first read an article by Tom Peters on the Fast Company website. It was called A Brand Called You, and I'll include a link in the description. But basically it was about how you should consider yourself to be the CEO of Me Inc. See, I told you it was corny, right? But it made a lot of sense. It said, one of the things with the future coming and more jobs being shipped overseas, with job market shrinking all the time, you have to find ways to differentiate yourself from everybody else. Especially, and I think it really applied in software development. See, my problem was a lot of the work I had done prior to this, like technology work, was in investment banks. So it was on an intranet site someplace. I couldn't share it with anybody. They never heard of it. So I just had to describe it. Oh, I worked on a compensation system. I worked on this system. I worked on that. So I started writing a blog. Every time I come across a technical problem, I could blog about it. I could blog my thoughts about certain technologies, what I was excited about, what I wasn't excited about. And I tell you what, I got teased about this a little bit from people who found out about it. So, oh, Eric and his blog, right? But it was what it was. But I found that on my CV, I didn't just have my job experience and whatever hobbies and everything. I could also point to different articles that I had written. I could point to blog posts. I could do all that kind of stuff. And most of the times when I went for an interview, when we talk about these kind of things, my ideas were already solidified because I was thinking about that. I would take on jobs that were interesting because I thought that would be better from a branding point of view than they were from a pay point of view, because always thinking, how do you market yourself going forward? And as a contractor, marketing yourself is one of the most important things you can do. But as an employee, it's important also. I am always surprised whenever I look at CVs or I'm hiring somebody or for Overpass, or even when I had to interview people when I was working in investment banks, I was always surprised how many people didn't have a website, didn't have articles they could point to, they didn't have a YouTube channel. In this day and age, right? You know, they don't even have a social media presence. I'm still surprised how few people are on YouTube, right? Considering every time you discover a new problem or whatever, a new solution to a problem, you could share that with other people, like just as your responsibility. But most of the time it's that initial, I feel really embarrassed doing this, like I did at the beginning. You just have to get over that and do it. So it's something I want you guys to think about. If you're a software developer, think about the personal brand. If you're gonna do your own company one day, it will help in that matter, because you can think about, how do I want everything to look? How do I want everything to be positioned? And also think about yourself. How do you present yourself when you go to a new employer, to a new prospect, whatever? You're thinking, you know, what do you have behind you? If someone were to Google you, what would they find? And it's easier than ever before to do it now. And as a software developer, I think you should have some apps on the app market, stuff that you can point to, or maybe a GitHub project that you contribute to. I think all this stuff is very, very important now. And I think it's something that, you know, as corny as it is, brand you kind of stuff, you know, I think it's really important. So let me know, do you agree with me, disagree with me? Like I said, a lot of people's like, oh, Eric and his blog or whatever. You just have to put up with that kind of stuff. And that's what makes it hard. It makes it hard as the people who just want to naysay to it and everything like that. So anyway, let me know what you think. Do you agree or disagree? And that is it for today. I'll talk to you tomorrow.